Now, I'm going to show you guys a spot that you can go through and grind a ton of candy very quickly. I am not going to talk about the Shattered Throne method or the Last Wish raid method. The method that I'm doing is simply open up your map and you go to destinations. On destinations, we're going to go over to the moon. And on the moon, we're going to go at the top right-hand side over here to Sorrow's Harbor. This is available for free-to-play players as well as people who own any part of the game. Now, it does appear that if you don't pick up the candy within a certain amount of time, that it does despawn. Because I did put a ton, I did have a ton of candy here, but it is looking like some of it is respawning. So I'm going to, or despawning. So I'm going to go through and pick it up quickly. But all you're going to do is simply just kill these waves of enemies. Like I said, no barrier to entry at all. All you have to do is simply fast travel here. You can come here for 5 minutes if you have some spare time. There's no time commitment to this at all. And if the waves of enemies start to get too hard for you, if you're solo or something like that, then what you can do is you can simply just let the event end. In about 30 seconds to a minute, the event will start back up again, and it will go back to tier one. And you'll be able to simply just farm the event again. Now, it should be very quickly noted that you do need to wear the Festival of the Lost mask that you received at the beginning of the quest for the Festival of the Lost. And if you have it equipped, then you should be receiving tons of candy. And also, you can go through and collect or get the candy from using any weapons. They don't have to be a particular weapon or abilities. You just kill with anything and you will have a chance to receive a piece of candy as a drop. Although I do have to be honest with you, it seems like you do get a ton of candy from doing the actual event itself while getting the pages too. So if you wanted to come here and just farm a bunch of mobs, you definitely can do that while completing other bounties and things. Maybe you're trying to get a bunch of Bright Dust together to buy the different rewards from the Season of the Lost in the Eververse shop. But if you simply go to the tower, and in the tower, you just go to this playlist activity here, you actually end up getting a ton of candy from doing this and also from completing the bounties from Eva as well. So you can use this method to just farm out a ton of candy by just mindlessly killing the endless mobs that spawn there. Or you can go through and do the actual event itself, but you definitely want to make sure that you're going through and completing these bounties as well, because you can actually get the bonus bounties here, and the bonus bounties do still reward you with candy. So the bonus bounties give you 20 candy each, the regular daily bounties give you 30 candy each, and the weekly bounties give you 500 candy each. The bonus bounties and the weekly bounties also give you Bright Dust. You can go through and complete these bounties on multiple characters, or you could just farm the bonus bounties by using this method here, or going through and doing the actual activity located in the tower here. You can get a ton of candy from doing this and farming this as well. I hope this video helped. If it did, consider checking out the playlist linked on screen now or in the description for a ton more of Destiny 2 Festival of the Lost videos. Thank you guys so much for watching. Have a great day, everybody.